Good evening, Toastmasters.
Good evening. Good evening.
Once upon a time, the speaker took us on a beautiful journey of a story, quintessential good and evil story. We had a poor brother and a rich brother, a good brother and an evil brother. We've all heard these stories throughout our life, but what was extremely good about this story was the uniqueness that the speaker brought onto this. She gave us two relatable names, Vishnu and Nandu, instead of Tom and Dick, which there could have been anybody else. She told us about a story where both these brothers, how they started, how they parted, and it ended with a very strong moral. But what I like the most about the speaker is her voice modulation. She is a master of voice modulation. I especially liked how she spoke about two particular lines, which were, suddenly the eagle swooped upon the sparrows and took it away. And then when she was explaining the pumpkin, it burst into 1,000 pieces to give more effect to the speech. Now why is that important is that when you are delivering a speech, to capture the audience's attention from time to time, you should be able to modulate your voice. The second thing that I liked a lot about the speaker was her eye contact. She maintained constant eye contact with the entire audience through a lighthouse approach. She made sure that everybody in the audience was feeling part of the story. The third thing I liked about her was her hand gestures. She made sure that she brought life to the story with her hand gestures. She said, 1, 2, and 3. The three seeds, the first seed gave this, the second seed gave this, the third seed gave us this. I also liked how she pointed when the knife was coming to cut the pumpkin. It again brought more life into the story. Having said that, there are certain parts of the speech the speaker could improve upon, which I felt that were missing. One was particularly her focus on this part of the audience. She did not move throughout her speech towards this part of the audience. That was something that I noticed. She could have spoken about the two brothers or spoken about the three pumpkins, 1, 2, and 3, divided the stage and spoken, given the story in that way. The second thing also which I felt that she could have improved upon was giving an effective pause in between. Especially when she asked the question, do you think they touched the third pumpkin? She could have waited for the audience to absorb that question, give a yes or a no reply, and then go on ahead. Those are a couple of things that I think that she could have improved upon. But all in all, great voice modulation, great eye contact, and fantastic hand gestures. If you could improve upon the stage movement and pauses, I think the speech would become even better. Thank you.